very special guest with us. He is an esteemed member of the Aquarium's board, as well as the Seafood for the Future Advisory Board. Sam King is a USC alum. He is an entrepreneur who has a network of seafood restaurants throughout Arizona, Nevada, Southern California, and now a new one opening in Texas. And I believe you just told me about another one that you had. Scott Seafood in Costa Mesa. So he's a growing business. He opened his first restaurant about 35 years ago. He was one of the first restaurateurs to actually take Chilean sea bass off of the menu after learning about the overfishing and illegal fishing practices with Chilean sea bass. He sits on the Ripley Advisory Board. He has been a wonderful advisor to the Seafood for the Future program, and we're very excited to hear from his point of view as such a successful entrepreneur what responsible aquaculture, and particularly aquaculture in the Southern California Bay, means to Sam King and his many restaurants and businesses. And I should also mention that he has a distribution arm to his seafood business as well.
And don't forget that announcement we promised we would make for Wade.
Yes, and I will make that announcement again at the end, but there will be another panel discussion for aquaculture at Cal State Long Beach next Thursday from 5 to 7. I'll give you more information at the end when I review the flyer again. And Sam will be there as well.
Right, yeah. Well, thanks so much for having me. I'm always excited when I get an opportunity to talk about aquaculture and sustainability. Jeremy and I have been at this a very, very long time. I think I've been a member of the board of the Aquarium probably for 11, 12 years. And I got to say that, I know you guys know all about Jerry. You've worked with him and you've dealt with him. Know how smart and intelligent he is in regards to about everything. But we should be very proud of the work and dedication that he's put forth in making sure that the discussion is balanced, because I think the balance is something that I'm going to talk about today. I'm going to share a little frustration tonight. You'll hear a little bit about that. This is probably the eighth exact, almost identical slideshow, eighth time I've done this. Jerry and I have done it together in Boston. We've seen the show a couple times. And still today, California has grabbed a defeat in the jaws of victory and still decided not to embrace aquaculture. So that's all for it. Let me tell you a little about our company. King Seafood Company started in, well, actually I started the business in 19, actually upon my life, I guess. My dad came out, an uncle came out with Minnesota in 1945 and started a small coffee shop chain in Southeast Los Angeles. I grew up in Downey, it was Huntington Park, Southgate. It's a great, great time where you grow up. Yeah. Boy, then we were in the coffee shop business. Grew up as a busboy, working manager vacations. Really, really fortunate that I got a really rich, deep understanding of the business, and I'm really enjoying it. So I followed my dad's footsteps. We sold that company in 1981 to Tiny Nailers, who was a private coffee shop chain at the time. Anybody here might remember them. And then my cousin and I started our present company called King Seafood Company. Where we opened our first restaurant was the 555 in Long Beach. We just signed a new lease. We've been there 31 years. We just signed another lease for 20 years. That means that hopefully the family's going to be in that spot at least 50 years. And actually, we are stronger than ever right now, which is really exciting to say. So we are, and then we open up, we also have a fish house over on Pine Avenue, too. So grew up in the business. 31 years ago, started this company. About 2 years after we opened up 555. We had a location in Santa Monica on Ocean Avenue in Santa Monica Boulevard. And at that time, our mantra was find a great location, see what's missing in that area, and fill the niche. And the seafood was the one niche that we decided to fill. And interesting enough, in doing my discovery, I did not realize how thin the seafood business was in Southern California, where we really didn't have comparable to New Orleans or Seattle or Boston, San Francisco, we really didn't have this culture. We had this passing recipes from you know, generation to generation. It was really very little seafood culture at all, so we had to come up with a way and kind of make our own little seafood restaurant, and which we found as to be a great opportunity, but it required me to do a heck of a lot of research. I had to travel all around the country to learn about seafood. I had to find a lot of different purveyors. Santa Monica Seafood is the big, terrific seafood purveyor in Southern California. I'll never forget talking with the Sugimano brothers, his family that owns it. And I said, I want to have 7 or 8 varieties of oysters every day. And they said, well, that's great. Because they only brought in the blue point. Back then, that was the only oyster. Kumamoto's were just starting to come about. And they go, that's great, but who are we going to sell, you know, the other, you know, 10 dozen to? If we sell you 10 dozen, we'd buy 20 dozen. And I said, well, that's not really my problem. Please, you know, visit this oyster. So, very proud to say that I think that we definitely were the ones that started the oyster revolution here in SoCal. And developed a program that we're very, very excited and proud of today. So we went on, we opened up our water room downtown Los Angeles, which was the next restaurant we opened up. We had the what was called Pine Avenue Grill. The fish house was called Pine Avenue Grill before. And then we changed that to Pine Avenue Fish House. And then we changed it again about 5 years later, and we changed it to King's Fish House. And that was approximately 21 years ago. We got the opportunity to have the door section. The original restaurant was just the front section, and we had the door section about 21 years ago. So over that time, we built, and we now have 11 King's Fish Houses throughout Southern California, and we have one in Henderson, Nevada, and one in Tempe, Arizona. And then our other side of our business is called King's Signature Group. Where I mentioned we have the 555, we have a restaurant in the Gaslamp area of San Diego called Luna Keys, which is another prime steakhouse, and it's a lot like the 555 menu. We got an opportunity to put together an RFP for a place, 1,200 square foot place, on the pier in Santa Monica, and just by a whim, we decided to fill it out. We decided that a burger place would be a great place to go there. And it was the greatest, probably single decision in the history of companies. This is like 2009. I mean, just when things were just tanking, our sales dropped $15, $16 million from 08 to 09. What the hell are we going to do? And we found this location. And today, out of 1,200 feet, we'll do almost $3.3 million. It is nuts how crazy and how successful we've been there. So, anybody here from the Shake Shack? You know, which is finally coming to, I think it's coming to WeHo. It's going to be the first location in SoCal, but it's a lot like that. We serve great burger, great custard shakes, and it's been incredibly successful. And it really kind of saved us a little in regards to we opened up very busy. But people don't talk about seafood yet. Burger place kind of really help care as long as it helps. We don't care. And we have the water grow. We had a very successful. Restaurant for 20 years. You guys talked about consumers who was here last week, I believe.
He gave a lecture. He wasn't in this.
Oh, he wasn't in this class. Yeah, Michael actually worked for us for 6.5 years at Water Grill. Was a terrific chef. Got us a 1-star Michelin star, and he was just a terrific young man, a terrific cook, and really helped the restaurant a lot. About 4 years ago, as downtown was changing and growing, and demographics were very exciting. We had a restaurant that was very scaly, good at front waiter, back waiter. It was pretty not continental, but it was very, very a little stiffer than it needed to be. So we remodeled it 3 years ago, and we opened back, picked up sales 50-60%, and it made us very happy. And then we got an opportunity to remodel our Ocean Avenue seafood restaurant, which again, when restaurants are open 20-25 years, you got to change them. You know, they have design changes about every 12-15 years. It's almost like a design changes with every like recession. And I think the thing that's really happened during this recession is the advent of the gastropub, and this whole design, steel windows, odd colored wood beams, what have you, is a design that's definitely transformed into that. We did that at our restaurant in Santa Monica, and we almost tripled business. It was another one of those very fortunate times in our business. We got an opportunity to take over the Palm, again in the Gaslamp area of San Diego. They closed a year ago on New Year's Eve, and we came in and remodeled the building and put water earlier. It was a beautiful building. If you guys ever get a chance to go down, you'd be really proud of a Long Beach company, based company originally. We did a really nice job there. It's a really beautiful restaurant. So, Three Water Grills is, as I said, we're opening fourth in Dallas, probably November next year, along with we just signed a lease and we announced it. We're taking over Scott's Seafood in South Coast Plaza. We'll open in August next year. Big restaurant, 17,000 square feet, big monster place, outside bar, inside bar. We have just a terrific plan for the building, and we think we should be and hope to be very